Good afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is DSP News, the Unreliable Ones. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the newsroom and welcome to the Gautopia News Network, your unreliable source for DSP News. This is the Snore Report. Let's go ahead and get into it. Ladies and gentlemen, I have a special broadcast for you today. Oh yes, oh yes. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to take you guys back to the year of 2015. February 11th, to specify. At a time where Phil was a little bit desperate, and he had to be willing to part with some things that were relatively important to him. I'm talking about the Great Statue Sale. Imagine getting all these amazing keepsakes for literally pennies on the dollar. Not really. I have three videos for you. First one's going to be the big announcement of the statue sale that happened February 11th, I think, of 2015. I have a video by Snor Purnell, one of our favorites. DSP Gaming, again, trying to sell broken statues. And who has the pants? Oh, who's wearing the pants in this relationship? That should be fun. And then I'm going to bring you guys to April. It might have been May or June of 2015, which is basically an update video Phil did on what statues were left. So that's pretty much what this is all going to encompass. Now, I will link down in the description if you guys didn't get a chance to see it. Tevin actually did a video going over this. This is right around the time Phil was announcing that he was trying to sell some statues, or someone bought something from him after he and background checked him and everything. You'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. Tevin went and did a stream on it. It's a really good stream. I'll leave the link of it down in the description. You guys can check it out in its entirety. But that gave me the idea to kind of tie some of this in. Instead of going through all the individual statues, I'll just go through when he started it and then the halfway point. I feel that'll be better. And then a little bit of Snor Purnell in between, because, you know, you need somebody who has talent to kind of carry the day on all this, right? And that's pretty much it, ladies and gentlemen. I will see you guys for the beginning of the video in just a second. Ladies and gentlemen, this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking. Unreliable coverage that you can't count on. A GTG network in production. You guys all know the slogan. I don't smell no bacon cooking yet, but we're going to see some broken statues. The Snort Report is always bringing you something new. It's time to watch me work.
To call the nook. What you're looking at right now is the storage nook that, if you were actually in my bedroom, which I'm backing up into right now, is actually a little, you know, side area off of my bedroom that used to be used as like a mini office. Now, we didn't set this up as an office.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here with the King of Hate Vlogs, February 11th, 2015. Announcement, statues for sale. I can feel the bacon grease already. Let's go.
Because it actually has a skylight, and both for myself, for my recording purposes, and Leanna for her soap making, we decided that the skylight would probably interfere with our businesses more than anything, and so we kind of just took it and turned it into storage when we moved here in June of last year. However, since then, we really haven't made any use of it, and what we decided to do, starting this week, is I'm going to go into this nook, I'm going to grab a statue, I'm going to profile it, meaning I'm going to open it up, show you everything about the statue, the condition it's in, I'm going to show you what it's going
for. Jesus Christ, Phil, hold the camera still. All that swaying back and forth and shit, goddamn, it's getting on my nerves. Oh, man.
Roughly online, and I'm going to offer this for sale, because let's face it, I'm not, you know, in my late 20s anymore. I don't live by myself as a bachelor in Connecticut in a small condo anymore, and I don't really need these. These were things that at one time, you know, when I didn't know I was going to have a girlfriend I was living with, and I didn't know I was going to have a bigger house, and I was going to be doing this full-time as a business, it was something that was kind of just to decorate a place, a bachelor pad, and now times have changed, and I really want to think. The way I look at it is this. They've been sitting here since June of last year.
This is what really happened, if I had to guess. Panda was like, get rid of that shit. Because Phil initially, and you'll see it in the Tevin video, Phil initially was going to decorate the house with all this stuff. And we're assuming that Panda wouldn't let him. And Panda probably had stuff that she wanted to put in there, or she had an idea for that room. And she was like, sell that shit or throw it away. And Phil's like, well, I can't sell it. You know what I'm saying? It's worth money. And we need the money to pay our bills. And she was like, then sell it. Okay. And so that's what ended up happening, basically. He's trying very hard to make it sound like he's making an adult decision, right? But if they're so valuable, you would keep some of it. He has a closet in his room, in his office. He could put it in there with the rest of the broken toys that he has in there with all the other broken toys that he has. And if it was in there, I would assume Panda wouldn't care. So I'm thinking that either Pando just wanted to see that shit gone, or she had plans for that room.
They're not doing anyone any good.
Nook, sorry.
Let's sell them. Let's get them in the hands of people who will enjoy them. In addition to that, it's definitely going to help me with my finances, with all the bills and stuff that I accrued when I moved here. All right. So I'm about to do, this is the preview video. I'm actually going to walk back here, and I'm going to show you what we're looking to sell. And there's some 31 items back here that are all ready to go, pretty much, because they all are super duper packed. All these boxes are full of styrofoam that's custom made to fit the figurine or whatever it is that's inside of it, okay? So just to show you some of the things that are going to be available for sale as I juggle with this stupid beanbag that wants to fall down and
kill. Are there arcade sticks in there too? I think there was. I think it was to his far right. Look like maybe it might have been like either a Tekken 7 or maybe a Street Fighter one, maybe a Street Fighter 4.
Let me hear. The Incredible Hulk, insanely large statue, one of the first ones I got, right? The Super Street Fighter 4 Sagat statue, that's one of the last ones I got. We've got Shredder from Ninja Turtles. We've got an Emma Frost figure. Under there, we've got the Boomer from Gears of War 3.
Yeah, I'm sure he's not trying to part with that Emma Frost one. Look at how he squandered his money. This is how he squandered his money. He's talking about how stuff came up, and I ran into financial issues, and that's why I need your guys' help now. No, he squandered his money on stupid shit. You know what I'm saying? And he liked the idea of being able to whip out that credit card and charge a couple thousand at a time. And people thinking, oh, Phil's so cool. Phil's so successful. Ooh. That's not... I'm sorry. And he wasn't. And years later, it don't mean nothing. It's garbage. He wants to put it in the hands of people who really want it, who really care about it. I'll say, Phil, you lucky that I was not into all this shit back then. Because I bought a few. He's just so I can make a video saying, look what I purchased from Dark Side Phil. Now, how much are y'all willing to pay to watch me destroy it? Oh, man, I would have made a shitload of money off that. Holy shit, that would have been dope. Someone should do that. I'm not saying that they should, but if they want to, they should. I will endorse it. All right, let's continue.
A bronze statue. We've got the Super Skrull that I bought before Marvel vs. Capcom 3 was released. Darksiders War and Ruin lit up statue. It actually lights up via USB power. We've got a Blanka statue. We've got Leonardo from Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Guile back there in the corner is actually incredibly rare from what I've seen.
Incredibly broken.
Replica weapons. It's a Gears of War replica weapon used in Project 7. Next to that, we have a Mass Effect 3 replica assault rifle.
Tevin's right, too. He's probably not going to end up parting with that that Gears of War weapon and whatnot. It's probably one of the few things that he owns that John has touched. So he's probably not going to let that go.
incredibly valuable because it's actually rare that it actually gets delivered anywhere and not destroyed, if you can believe it. We've got an Emma Frost bust, Black Cat bust, the Isaac Clarke Dead Space.
Okay, no problem. He must have had a real hard-on, though, for Emma Frost. Goddamn. I mean, or maybe he just appreciates a nice pair of titties. I can give him points on that.
Light-up statue. There's a Thanos and Lady Death statue. I'm just showing you initially what I can without moving anything. But just to show you how much shit I got down there. Poison Ivy. We've got the... This is actually a portal gun replica gun that I got from GameStop for redeeming like some 200,000 GameStop points that I saved up over the years buying games at GameStop from their club.
And then doing giveaways with empty boxes. Let's not forget that.
So this here, something else that says Gears of War. Oh, that's the snub pistol. That was used in Project 7. The Duke Nukem statue right here, look. So this is just very quick, just showing you what I have to offer in regards to the statues I'll be looking at. There's many, many more, by the way. There's a whole other level underneath here that I'm not going to dig into right now. But this is the stuff that I'm going to be offering. How it's going to work is very simple.
So, I have statues on... I have goods to be sold. But I'm not going to actually move anything around and do anything like that. Nothing that inconveniences me. I'm just going to tell you that I have stuff for sale. I'm going to show you a little bit of it. That's pretty much it. I'm making a video that I'm going to monetize and put on my channel, saying that I'm having this big statue sale and I want to try to garner as much attention as possible. But I'm not going to go out of my way to try to clean that, to organize it a little bit to where, even if he doesn't get to all of them, to get to the majority of them. So people have a better idea of what's going on. They shouldn't have to freeze frame this video frame by frame to see what's there and what's not.
Like I said, one a week probably, or probably one every 2 weeks. I don't want to rush it and have too many going at once. I'll grab one of these. I'll take it out of the box. I'll show you exactly what it looks like. I'll tell you what it's going for online. And then I'll say, listen, please contact me with serious offers. I am going to warn everyone preemptively, and I'll mention this every time. If you're international to the United States, I don't recommend you get interested. I'm going to say that again. If you're international to the United States, I live in Washington State on the west coast of the United States. Unless you're close, like maybe Canada, all right? I don't recommend that you get interested. The reason being, shipping is absolutely incredibly fucking expensive. Just recently, this past week, I mailed out all of these figurines, these Mario Brothers figurines that are just plastic. They don't even weigh anything, okay? From the Hardcore Gaming Season giveaway contest that I held in late fall of last year. I mailed it to places like Venezuela, Germany, there was one in Argentina, there was one in, oh god, there was one that was way out there. But anyway, those cost, I shit you not, about $100 to ship, and the box is probably the biggest box, was the size of this Super Scroll right here, but it weighed like not even a pound. This one probably weighs about 15 to 20 pounds because of the weight of the statue. $100 to ship it. I can imagine some of these things, to ship them internationally, would cost hundreds and hundreds of dollars. So what's the point if you really want this Shredder statue?
I mean, are you overnighting it? Or, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, what are we doing? Like, are you express shipping this shit or something? Because if not, it's not that... it's debatable, but it's not as expensive as he's saying. Not hundreds of dollars. I've shipped shit overseas, dude. You know what I'm saying? 20, 30, 40 bucks, sure. But not hundreds of dollars.
Right? And you're going to offer me $300 for it, and I accept, but then you end up paying $200 to ship it to your house. Probably not worth it, okay? But the good thing is a lot
of... Unless you were willing to factor the shipping cost into the actual... into the actual price, which he ends up bringing that up later on. Because there was some people in the international market who were, in his international fan base, I'm sorry, that were interested in getting in. So he made that caveat just for those who really wanted it.
Very rare. Look, a lot of these statues that I got were in limited quantities. This one only had a 500 run. It looks like the Emma Frost bust up here had a 1250 run. A lot
of them probably for the first edition, just saying, to be honest. And then who knows about special editions and then collector's editions and things like that. Whatever, Phil. Whatever.
Low number. So these are pretty limited collector's edition items. And I took care of them. I think with the exception of two of these things, none of them have any damage. They have all the accessories, the original packaging. They're ready to go.
He said except for two. Let's see if we can debunk that. The Guile statue is messed up. I think there's something wrong with the dog tag. I think there's something wrong with the hand that holds the comb and something else. I know that for sure. That Guile one's all screwed up, which is kind of a shame. The She-Hulk one of the magnetic hands is damaged too. The one that's actually holding like the, it's a traffic meter. Not a traffic meter, I'm sorry. It's a parking meter, I think. That one's damaged, because I remember watching that in Tevin's video. And there's another statue, too, that's damaged. Not the Cobra Commander. That one's fine. There has to be another one that has some type of issue with it. And he tried to pig-splain it away like it was no big deal. And there was a rare one, too. That's the reason why he couldn't even try to maneuver it for the going price on it, because he knew it was messed up. All right, Phil, you win this one. We're just tied. I'm not going to say you win. We're 2-for-2. I know there's a third one, though. If it comes to me, I'll bring it up.
In prime mint condition, okay? So this is just a preview video to get your appetite wet, right? You're getting excited now. A lot of people are probably saying, man, I heard that Phil had that statue. Yeah, I do have the She-Hulk statue down here that I'm going to profile. It's worth a shitload of money. People online are selling it for over $1,000. And by the way, I'm going to be offering these primarily for discounted prices, meaning, let's say, for example, that She-Hulk statue, right? You really want it.
And everyone, that's the one that's broken, too, by the way.
I'm selling it for $1,500. I'm probably not going to sell it for $1,500. I'll probably
And $1,500 is what someone else is willing to sell it for. That's not what it's worth, first off and foremost. So Phil was picking and choosing the prices that he saw online to kind of use as the measuring stick. And this was really more of an auction. You weren't just coming to buy. It was more of an auction. Because if not, he would have just gone to eBay or something else. But he explains that too, that he wanted to cut out the middleman. He didn't want to give anybody else any money, and that's why he wouldn't go through eBay.
For several hundred.
Like I said, I'll link Tevin's video down in the description. It goes over. I don't think Tevin went over every statue, but he went over the majority of them.
Less than that, because I want him to move. I don't want this stuff to sit here in this nook for the next 3 years when I could be using this money to pay down all that debt that I accrued moving across the country. So that's the ideal thing here, is to get rid of the stuff. It's nice, it's a great condition, but I don't have any use for it anymore. Get it out, and then hey, then I can finally use this
nook. Okay, I was right. The arcade stick is right there in your top right hand corner. It's right in front of the Last of Us. He's doing all this swerving and shit, and the shit was starting to get me nauseous. Okay, so that's what it was. And he has actually, that's the Street Fighter 4, that's the white one, yeah? Yeah, he has a bunch of those, because I think I've seen in his condo video, he has like two of the black ones also. And those were the miniature version. I don't even think those were the full arcade ones like the ones I have. Huh, okay.
Move stuff in here that we want for storage and stuff, and we can make use of the space in our house that basically right now is wasted because I got all this junk, okay? Alright, so that is
all it. All this junk. It originally started off as all these collectibles that, you know, he'd like to pass on to people who he would actually want. Now it's been reduced to junk. The devil's in the details, ladies and gentlemen.
For the initial preview video of the Nook, later this week I'll be selecting one of these items for offer, for sale, and then we'll get started, okay? I'm curious to know, out of just the stuff that you guys saw, what people would be really interested in. When you actually take a look at some of these online, you're going to see they're worth a lot of money. So, all right, that is it, everyone.
Goddamn, stand straight and stop swerving. This shit don't get on my nerves. I don't know how Tevin did it. This is annoying. Fuck. Oh, my gosh. And yet, someone's going to ask, hey, would you consider going through all those videos? I would, if someone really wants to see them. Jesus Christ, hopefully he's not swerving all crazy like this. Oh, Panda's there. Never mind, so Panda will probably be holding the camera. Maybe. Probably not. Oh, well. We miss you, Panda.
Thanks. Later this week, we'll pick one and we'll get started. So, I hope that you'll be interested. See you then.
This is how to play the game!
That is an epic fucking intro, dude.
And I have to warn everyone, warning, what you may see right now is going to be absolutely disgusting.
Sound good?
All right. Sounds good to me.
Viewership.
Oh, almost had her in that one. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are here at one of our favorite Snorpernel, DSP Gaming. Again, trying to sell broken statues. And who has the pants in the relationship? Let's go.
It's been great this week.
King of Golf HD says, I thought you don't check views. I actually don't, but ever since I started using Streamlabs, at the end of every stream now, they email me a stream summary to tell me the average viewers, which I didn't, you know, I wouldn't know, because I don't maintain stream viewership, but I've been seeing the emails coming in saying, oh, you had so-and-so number. I mean, for no lie, for Mortal Kombat 11.
I mean, he's right. He doesn't actually maintain stream viewership, meaning that he can't really hold an audience for a long period of time unless there's drama or some bullshit. That's the way I'm looking at it. Also, on top of that, he can see stream viewership on Muggsy. It was right in front of him. This is how many people are on the stream. So he always knew. I never understood why he does that. Like, he tries to downplay it like he's not, you know, obsessed with it. You could see, to be honest with you, in past streams, that how his attitude would fluctuate when the stream views were high or low. So, and he called people lazy at one time. We've gone over this.
Like, between, I'd say, anywhere from 600 to 1,000 people per stream.
Day one views. Day one inflated views. Make the money. Views, views, views. I don't want to be Mr. Views.
That's great viewership, but at the same time, it doesn't necessarily equate to repeat viewership. You know, these people may only be around to see me play Mortal Kombat 11 and then not come back for anything else. And in addition, these are people coming in to see me rage. They're not necessarily here to be a positive contribution to the streams, if you know what I'm saying. Okay? It's like short-term popularity versus long-term success. So I understand that as a variety streamer...
But you've never been concerned with long-term success. You, for some reason, as I've said before, you thought you were going to age like wine. And you didn't. And if you had planned for long-term success, you would have saved your money. That's just one of the fundamental... That's one of the fundamental acts that needs to be taken place for long-term success. And you didn't do that. You spent your money on frivolous bullshit. You wanted people to perceive you as being successful. So you bought what you interpreted as the trappings of success. Even if it alienated the very people who helped you get to where you're at. Just saying. DSP News.
Definitely need to do more than just playing one style of game. All right. No online play. All right, I'm going to tell you this right up front, everyone. There's no online play today in Mortal Kombat 11. Don't worry, there's going to be plenty more coming this week. But there's none today. We're purposely taking a break from it to give me a more relaxing situation here. Less stress. If you have an issue with that and you don't want to see the offline content, that's fine. Come back at a later date. Don't sit here spamming.
Wait, you getting your ass handed on you was so stressful that you had to run back to story mode? Or you had to run to some offline mode? Holy shit. Oh, he's going to drop this game in no time. That's exactly what this is starting to sound like. Because, ladies and gentlemen, that's what people really want to see. Him playing story modes, he should play that at night as a chill stream type shit and whatnot. The story mode's not bad, or at least the storyline for Mortal Kombat's not bad. I don't know how I feel about the time traveling thing, but it is what it is. It's a carryover from 10. So that is what that is. But if you're coming to his main stream, the morning stream where all the money's made and all that, I want to see some online play. I want to see his ass get handed to him. I'm trying to see people cut some bacon off his back. That's why I'm there. I'm there to hear all the sizzling and crackling and whatnot. Not to sit there and watch him go through fucking... story mode or go through the crypts and all that bullshit. That don't mean nothing to me. And I'm not here to have a relaxing I'm not here to see him have a relaxing time. I want to see him tense. I want to see him stressed. I want him to see him struggle. That's what I want. Period. If not, why is he playing a fighting game? Have him play Minecraft or some other dumb shit. That's the point. That's why viewership for Mortal Kombat is dwindling. Because you're an idiot. You're an absolute fucking idiot. And yet again, putting personal comfort in front of what's entertaining. People come there to watch you rage and watch you fail. If you succeed, cool. But that's what they're there for. And you can't even give them that. because Mortal Kombat's stressing you out so much. Despite the fact, ladies and gentlemen, that the same idiot played Super Turbo till the wheels fell off, got beat multiple times for hours on end, and didn't say a word about, oh, I need to stop playing this because I'm stressed out. He would just bitch and complain that he was losing, or what he was losing to. Fuck out of here. DSB News!
And asking for online play all day long in the stream chat, you're gonna get banned. I'm just saying that right up front. If you're gonna sit here and spam the chat with demanding things that I've up front said I'm not doing today, you're gonna get banned.
Well, I think I'm toxic now.
And I'm not gonna have any kind of appeals for it either, because you're being told up front, don't do it. Okay? That's gonna be considered stream derailing and just trolling and being annoying. So, up front, don't do it. Fair enough? I'm now giving everyone fair warning. It's okay if someone just comes in here and says, oh, why is Phil not playing online today? That's fine. But coming in, play online. Maybe you should play online. Come on, Phil, play online. Stop doing what you're doing and play online. Play online. Play online. Well, you're going to say toodles, and you're not going to be coming back.
I'm just going to ban.
All right. Now, I got a couple things I want to talk about. The first is Days Gone.
He's that upset because people want to see him play online. Holy shit. What the fuck are you so angry for? That's not even a good reason to be angry. Oh, God.
As you guys know, I'm not playing it. You know, it came out on Friday. Originally, it was a major consideration. It was a game that I was going to play. And then based on your feedback, you know, people actually telling me during the week, the game's not very good. It's going to basically be a game you stream once and people will be bored with. And you probably don't want to play it. All right? And based on the feedback of people who reviewed the game and played it early, everyone basically told me to skip it. So I did, and then for 2 days, all I got were complaints on the stream, why aren't you playing Days Gone? The bottom line is, I'm damned if I do, and I'm damned if I don't. If I had played Days Gone and balanced that with Mortal Kombat all week, I probably would have got complaints, why is there no chill streaming content? Why are you playing Days Gone? It's a boring game. You should have skipped it. Everyone told you it wasn't good. Now I skip it, and everyone says the opposite, right? That's how it always is with me, okay? Now here's the bottom line, guys. I am not going to spend $60 on Days Gone if it's a game that potentially I will stream once and everyone will be bored of it. I'm just being honest with you. I'm not going to do that. The days of that happening are over. I don't have a lot of disposable income to dump on a game that's going to be possibly a dud. All right? So if Days Gone gets much cheaper this week, I'll buy it. You know, $30? Sure, I'll buy it. Or if someone purchases the game for me and donates the code, then I'll play it.
And my ass is so fucking stretched out at this point, I'm open to people sending me stuff.
I have a statue collection, alright? And, well, when I moved across the country to Washington, I said, I don't want to have these out on display all through my house. These things have sat in a storage area in my house for 5 years collecting dust. When I first moved here, I was able to sell a few of them, because what I would do is I would do a video, and I would show you the item, and I would post it up on YouTube, and I would have a few potential buyers contact me. And I did actually sell a few of these at that time, okay? And the good news is, you know, it's not like I was selling them for exorbitant prices. I was selling them for actually under the value of what you would buy these items for online. So the people who bought them were getting a really good investment. And I was getting some extra money that I needed to pay bills. So it was a win-win. Sadly, what ended up happening was, over time, a bunch of people started trolling me and saying they were interested, and then they would basically just, you know, stop talking. So it wasn't worth it. I would put out a video. I would get like 25 offers for an item. Out of those, zero were serious. And at the point, I was just like, it's not worth the effort anymore. So for years, I just kind of sat on these. Now, the other night, I posted up on Twitter. You know, I got all these things.
So wait, so you didn't get the money that you felt that you should have gotten off these statues, so you just pulled them off the market and let it sit into that nook. Even though, in the video I showed you guys, he said that they had to go. He didn't have a whole lot of time to be sitting on them. He wanted to make sure that he could get them moved as quickly as possible. Okay. Okay.
He's sitting around that I could really use the money right now. And, you know, I have a bunch of dedicated fans. I wonder if anyone would be interested in these again. So, just posting up a few of the items I had, one very long-time fan and viewer of mine was interested in the portal gun. And we came to an arrangement, and boom, he bought it, and I'm going to be mailing it out to him this week. So that was really awesome, because this is someone who's been a longtime viewer and fan of mine, who, you know, it was very trustworthy, and I was like, wow, this is cool. Now, he's getting something for a very discounted price of what he would have to buy it for online. I'm getting rid of something that's been sitting in my storage nook for years and it, you know, is worthless to me, but has a lot of value to this guy, and it's going to help me out too financially. So this is awesome. And in addition to that, there's probably two other people who are very interested in a couple of my collectibles, who I'm in talks with right now.
Okay? It was worthless to him. He spent thousands and thousands of dollars on all that silly shit, but it's worthless to him. Just like that video game collection he don't want to talk about. Just like that Lion King video game that James the Lesser had brought up that's worth like $200 that he acts like he doesn't know nothing about. I.e., he's probably trying to sell it behind the scenes. It's all worthless to him. And yet, he threw all his money at it only 6 or 7 years ago. Gotcha.
So what I would say is this, all right? I am not opening up sale of these items to just anyone, but if any of you who are, you know, longtime fans or dedicated viewers are interested in these items, all right, you can email me at darksidephil@hotmail.com. However, I just want you to understand that just because you email me, it doesn't mean that I'm going to even pay attention to your email.
Unbelievable.
I'm looking basically for people who I know and trust. And you guys know who you are, longtime viewers, who I recognize by name, you know, mods, you know, that kind of people who are interested maybe in some of my collectibles. You guys honestly should get the first shot at them anyway, you know. You know, some of these statues, I'm not even kidding, some of these statues are selling online for about $1,000. I'm not looking for that, that's insane, you know. A few hundred dollars here or there helps me out, and you guys get something that's very highly valued.
No! Like, you just imagine shit in your head, you fabricate this shit in your head.
You know what I mean? So, anything is appreciated. Again, I would say, you know, contributions are much appreciated. They keep me going. Being very honest with all of you, Mortal Kombat 11 has been great for streaming. Not so great for YouTube because YouTube has been demonetizing videos. And in addition to that, YouTube, I've been getting my videos claimed, I'm not even kidding, by other people. People who put videos up on YouTube. Somehow my videos are getting third-party claimed. My gameplay with my commentary and my fucking face on it is getting claimed by third-party people because YouTube's system is a piece of shit.
There's a lot of silly shit. There's a lot of silly shit going on YouTube right now. It is what it is, to be honest. I'm sure they're going to get it worked out. You know what I'm saying? Just like how, what was it? What's that guy's name? It was some big YouTuber. I can't remember his name. Right? It might be Jacksepticeye. Like, had claimed a couple of his videos. He wasn't actually claiming Phil's videos. It was the people who Jacksepticeye has partnered with that was claiming videos of other content creators on his behalf. It ends up getting worked out. Jacksepticeye had nothing even to do with it. And he was like, dude, I have nothing to do with it, but we're getting it worked out. My apologies. But Phil wanted to make a big huff about it and shit, made himself look like an asshole. And, well, we all know where that happened, where it went from there. As it pertains to the statues, yeah, we'll see how that works. There's so much trolling and everything going on right now. And he has to make updated videos on it. You know what I'm saying? If you think about it, because Tevin had pointed this out also, praise be. That Panda's in a lot of those videos. So unless he's planning on replicating it, those videos with Cat, I mean, what are you gonna do, buddy? What are you gonna do? So that should be good. That should be real good. And most people don't even know where to find those statues. They don't know where to find those videos, I should say. So, you know, you gotta have people who are deep into the lore who's gonna remember that shit.
Why'd you do that? Why did you do that? Why'd you just go to bite mommy? Wow. Alright, so you see what pigs can do.
And it auto-claims videos for no fucking reason that aren't other people's property. So not only are my videos getting demonetized for violence, I'm also getting videos third-party claimed that I now have to dispute the claims. It's a fucking nightmare.
As I've said many times, you know, people will get what's coming to them. It's called karma.
Alright, it is. So, MK11's been great on stream, not very good on YouTube. So, if you love the MK11 coverage, you want to see it continue, and please...
Give me your money. Give me money, money!
SonicFighter25 cheered, 100 bits, you're the top cheerer so far tonight. He said, how's it going? I know you probably answered this. Are you playing Days Gone? You're right, I've already answered it. I'm not against playing it. But I'm against playing it as a $60 game. If someone donated the game to me, I would consider playing it. But when I say that, I mean if someone bought the game for me and sent me the PSN code for me to install and play the game right now, I would do it. But if someone's going to send me money, because someone already offered me a day or two ago to send me money to do it, I was like, no. When you send me money, all right, This causes a whole chain reaction of events for me, including having to pay taxes on the money you gave me, paying sales tax when I buy the game online. It's a big negative. It's like, just if you're going to buy the game and send me the PSN code, that's great. I accept it. And yeah, I would play it a little bit and balance it in with Mortal Kombat. But, you know.
No, I don't want you to start sending me money. Sorry, I don't need your quarters.
And by the way, I think the person who offered wasn't genuine anyway, because they would have went and bought the game and they didn't, right? But yeah, I'm not buying it for $60.
There was not a... Okay. So, this whole don't send me money thing is really interesting. And actually, when Phil came back from... When he came back from his wedding, right? From Connecticut. He had said something similar to that, too. He said that, you know, I'm not asking you guys to send me anything or give me money or anything like that. So, what's the new marketing scheme that he's trying to pull with this? And this definitely wasn't going to be something long-term, because eventually he's going to have to start begging for money again. So that's weird. So he doesn't want you to send him money directly because he's going to be taxed on it? It's not like if he goes through Twitch, he still can't get hit. I don't know. It sounds like he's about to pull some dumb shit that's going to get him in even more trouble. That's what that sounds like. Secondly, you gave the guy from 2 days ago, you basically explained to him that, yeah, you can send me the game, but I'm not going to play it on my main stream. And I'm probably only going to play it once or twice, and then I'm going to be done with it. Why would you... It doesn't mean that the guy isn't genuine. It's just he probably came to the realization that, why would I waste my money on you if you're not actually going to play the game for what it is? You know what I'm saying? Like, the guy saw that you were trying to take advantage of him, so he was like, well, I'll think about it. Or let somebody else do it. That doesn't mean the guy wasn't genuine. It just means he saw you for the piece of shit that you were. It's not hard to figure out.
$60 from what I'm hearing. If I can get it at a big discount, if it goes on sale the next 1 or 2 weeks, I'll get it then maybe and balance it. Or if someone donates the game. But those are the only circumstances that I'm going to be playing Days Gone. Frog in a Tuxedo cheered and said something about Velvet Seven's a new dress. I don't know what the hell you're talking about. And basically, if you want to stay in the chat and not get banned, I'm going to warn you right now, don't spam Frog emotes and don't bring up derailing stuff during today's stream, because I'm not going to be addressing it. So if you start bringing, I don't know who the fuck Velvet Seven is.
Oh, it was delicious. Oh, that was so good, man.
I don't, you know, start bringing up other things that are going to just derail the stream, you will find yourself with your boot to your ass, with my boot to your ass, and banned from the chat, okay? People are saying game codes are done on PS4. If game codes are done, then how are people getting review copies of games? Because that's how they're given out. You give out review copies with a review code, you enter, and you get the code, and that's how you get the game. So how are you going to tell me that there's no codes available for games on PS4 anymore? Physical disc would be pretty stupid to have to physically send a fucking disc to people instead of just sending a digital code. Why in the holy hell would they have done that? That makes no fucking sense at all. Oh, we have a whole fun digital system working where everything's easy to get and access. Let's still destroy that system completely.
All right, then how about this? If there's no more PS4 game codes, then send me a PS4 code for $60 of credit. On the system.
See what I mean? Because those still exist. Because I know for a fact they exist, because that's what they tell you to do if, for some reason, you're locked out of
life. You greedy fuck! You greedy, greedy, greedy fuck! So now we've come to the point where, first of all, I like how he brought up review copies from the hop. I love how he still has a stick up his ass about that, since he's always talking about shoving something up his ass. Might as well add to that shit. So it's funny how that was the first thing that's brought up. But now... Okay, well, if you guys can't get me the game code, go out and get me a PSN card, put money on it, and send me that code instead. I don't know what he's trying to pull, but that's just going to come back and bite him. That's going to come back and bite him later. Holy shit, Phil, have you not... You can't keep playing the system and thinking that you're not going to get slapped. Eventually, you're going to get slapped for this. No one's this greedy and this stupid to keep doing this dumb shit. Oh, fuck it, Phil. Oh my god, you're engineering your own demise. I'm mad that I called it, but you're engineering your own demise, and it's so unnecessary. It's entertaining, though, but it's not... So sad. So goddamn sad.
Digitally, because your payment is frozen or whatever, they tell you go buy one of those gift cards or whatever. Because that's what I would say. Wallet fund codes would work. Exactly, so that's what it is then. If, you know, Solid Fantasy says they do still send codes, ignore everyone, they're making it up. All right, I'll ignore it then. So either send me a game code or send me a code for the currency to buy said game if you want to donate. There you go. DSP T-Post Counter, who's obviously a troll, but actually asked a legit question, says, do you prefer donations in PS4 bucks because I feel like that would help you out more. Dude, yeah, if anyone wanted to donate PS4 currency, you know, for PSN, yes, because all my games I purchased digitally, that would help immensely. You know, you might say, oh, well, I thought you need funds to help with your bills. You're right, but if I don't have to spend money to buy the games, then that's money that can go towards the bills. You see what I'm saying?
But doesn't absolutely that work the exact same way if people just sent you the game directly? It works the exact same way. But you sure as hell weren't this excited about that being a prospect. Now you're saying that, oh, yeah, send me the money directly. Or send me PSN currency or Xbox currency. And that'll work out so much better. It works the exact same way. I swear he doesn't think before he talks. I swear you don't. You really don't.
I would accept that as a donation. Absolutely. My mod had that name. Is he a troll? Yes. Yes, my mod is a troll. You didn't know that? How would you go about sending me that sort of donation, DSP Postcounter
ad? Oh, Phil. And see, that's the thing. Now that the power structure, if you want to call it that, has been ruptured, now we're going to, this is where we're going to have a lot of, this is where the vacuum starts to come into play. And now, a lot of these individuals who are deep cover trolls are now going to get into the mix of it. Phil, you're such an idiot, dude. Yeah, you're such an idiot. Why'd you let this shit happen? The very control that you coveted, you're now losing from the inside. Oh my god, they finally got into you on some deep cover shit. Cause some people think John Cuck, he's not going by John Cuck anymore. He's going by something else now. I don't think he's DSP T-Pose though, or T-Counter. But some people think John Cuck is like an undercover troll too. And what? And he must be dedicated because he's been deep cover for a while. God damn it, Phil, you're an idiot. That's alleged though. I have no evidence of any of that, by the way. I'm not trying to ruin anybody's fun and whatnot, and I don't want to put any false allegations on anybody. That is all alleged. Help!
DSP T-Post counter has, you gotta buy the gift cards. Those PSN gift cards, and they all have codes right on them. So all you do is you buy a PSN gift card, you send me the code, and then I can enter it on my PS4, and that's how I guess I would get that currency in there to buy games with and stuff. Okay?
What pasta do you prefer? I prefer a penne.
Oh!
Easy to eat.
Oh!
Phil's a faggot. Phil's fat.
I'm sorry. Okay. Okay, so let me tell you from all this shit. Oh, so someone ended up, it looks like someone's gonna end up forking up the money, or someone has forked up the money. Which, good on them. So, here, let me take a moment to do a quick look on some shit. That's fucking hilarious. Alright, so okay. Okay, so it appears that someone forked over the cash. Alright. Someone gave him $100 for the game, and then he has like a $40 incentive. $30, I guess, because Phil factor in taxes now, like he's Wings or some shit like that. Now this is how it goes. He ends up getting the donation. He basically pretends like the donation didn't happen, and he runs off and he tries to end the stream. Okay? Then people in the chat made a stink about it, as they're supposed to. Being like, yo, Phil, you can't leave without acknowledging. And Phil basically had to waddle himself back in and say that, oh shit, I did actually get the donation. I.e., I'm now playing Days Gone. Wow, I'm really surprised Phil would have tried to run on that. That's not cool. But, you know what I'm saying? That just goes to show, Phil ain't trying to play that game, dude. You know, he threw hurdle after hurdle after hurdle at these people. And they still got him. Amazing! Absolutely amazing. Alright, so... Alright, anyway, what's the big takeaway outside of that? The broken statue thing, I'm about to give you the last video of the broadcast for that. I mean, you know what I'm saying? If cat's calling shots, cat's calling shots. That is what that is. And his demeanor, I should say, on stream lately, has been something to behold. He's all kinds of pissed off. Apparently the honeymoon period is over, I guess. So make of that as you will. All right, let's go ahead and get into the last video of the broadcast. We'll see you in a minute.
Phil's a loser. Phil's a beggar. Phil's a racist. Phil's a scammer. DSP's a pedophile. DSP is a thief. DSP is a greedy fuck. What's
going on? This guy's a bitch.
I have a micro penis. Alright, I'm not dead, but I swear to God, I wish I fucking was.
Hello everyone, Darkside Phil here, and this is an update video. This is an update and addendum video for those who have been paying attention to me this year in regards to my statue collection. As you know, many of my statues in my collection have gone up for sale this year. Many of them have sold. Some of them were supposed to sell, but unfortunately never really got sold.
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're here for the last video of the broadcast. We are here with King of Hate Vlogs. We're here with King of Hate Vlogs. This is the July-August update of 2015. We'll see what this nook has to offer. Here we go.
Any interested buyers. I started getting some messages over the past couple of weeks saying, Phil, you know, what do you still have? What don't you have? What will be coming up later this year for sale, etc.? Can you do like a cumulative update video explaining so that we know exactly what you have left and we know what to expect? And I said, you know what? Fair enough. It's easy enough for me to just walk here into my nook area, this is the storage nook of my home, and show you what we've got left. So before we even get to the stuff that maybe has been up for sale and didn't go, what I'd like to do is show you some of the stuff that I have here that I have not offered yet that could possibly go up for sale. So just to start, who's some of this stuff? Looks like a robe's cord or something. That's weird. Let me move this beanbag if I can, and I will show you what I have left. Because there's lots of stuff I have not put up for sale yet. Alright, so here you go. An Emma Frost bust from X-Men. Similar to the Black Cat bust. This is Thanos and Lady Death. Thanos, of course, holding the Infinity Gauntlet. This is a Cobra Commander diorama from G.I. Joe. This is the Duke Nukem Forever statue that I own. This is the Cog Snub Pistol replica that I used in Project 7. I still have that. In the corner there, I've got the full-size Lancer. It's a retro Lancer replica that I used in Project 7. This is a full-sized Avenger replica gun. The thing is incredibly expensive, fragile, and rare. And it's worth a ton of money. I don't know if I'll ever put that up for sale because I don't think I'll ever even get nearly...
Which means if it's fragile, that means it's possibly broken. He just doesn't know it yet.
Money as I spent on it. I mean, I'm serious. That's a prop that I was going to use in Project 7 for several episodes. I was going to have all special effects and everything, and I spent a ton of money on it, and I never used it. We've got the tank from Left 4 Dead 2.
Well, yeah, dude, because the BMW won out. And when everybody saw you roll up, when everybody rolled up to your apartment, or sorry, your condo, with your new BMW out front, they were jealous of you, and that's why Project 7 failed, right? It's not your fault. It's their fault. You offered them money. You told John and Howard that you did, despite the fact that the guy, you know, Respect the Pack said you didn't offer them any money, and you said and you said they just wanted exposure and so on and so forth. So basically what you're saying is they did it all for free. And even when John was like, hey, throw them a little bit of cash so we can at least finish the project off. We can at least end sharp. And like I said, throw them a little bit of money so it compensates them for their time. Because one of them was having a kid. And more importantly than that, they were being offered other, you know, projects, other, you know, other jobs. But no, Phil, no, they don't want any money, man. They don't want any money. I'm not giving up any money. It's my money. It's my precious. And then everything fell apart. But then you want to blame it on everybody else for screwing up instead of yourself. Fucking amazing.
New statue. We've got a Scorpion statue from the Mortal Kombat reboot. That happened several years ago. The Incredible Hulk ginormous statue that used to sit in my living room in Connecticut.
Actually, you see that case that's right there in between the portal gun and that Mortal Kombat thing? I have a case similar to that that holds all my poker chips and stuff in it. I got like this like really expensive like poker set. I don't know, it's worth a couple thousand dollars or some shit like that. I don't know. I didn't buy it. I got it as a gift. And shit, I think I've only used it once because I like the poker set that I have. It looks, it comes in a case similar to that. But Phil don't play poker, so I don't know what's in there. But, that might be good to know, though. It's a nice case, though. It's still in good shape, anyway. We'll see if that's up for, sale.
Yeah. I've got that one. We've also got the Poison Ivy statue from Batman. This is the Mephisto faux bronze statue. I can't really show you what it is, but it's Mephisto from Marvel Comics. The soldier...
It's upside down! Because isn't that the barcode right there? The fuck are you... Oh, shit. It's upside down! Ah!
Blue... No, the Red Soldier from Team Fortress 2. This is the Joker premium format figure from Sideshow Collectibles. A portal replica gun. Yes, this is also incredibly valuable and rare because people love to use these for like cosplaying and also for different series. I got that for Project 7 and never used it. Not even opened. I never even opened the damn thing. She-Hulk statue. This is the one that was worth a ridiculous amount of money for a while in Ultimate Marvel.
Wait, so you were willing to throw all this crazy money on props and shit, which is fine, whatever. But you're willing to throw all this money down for props, but you weren't willing to throw a couple hundred dollars at the dude that was doing all the real work as it pertains to the editing, all the shooting, all the filming, and all that stuff? You wouldn't throw no money at them, but you're willing to spend all this money on props and everything. This is very backward-ass thinking, to say the very least.
Three was very popular. The heavy blue statue from Team Fortress 2. And this is the replica... Timson Tools plasma cutter. This one I can actually open for you. If I can figure out how. Look at that. That's right. Dead Space. And it's pretty good.
Okay, that's pretty dope. I wouldn't mind actually buying that. I really just want the case, but I'll go ahead and take the replica that's in it. What the fuck were you gonna... God damn, dude. So, like... You're a fucking idiot, Phil. You're a fucking idiot. Let me explain. You spent all this money on all these props, which means that you obviously had some idea... Well, you, John, and Howard, and Respect the Pack, obviously had some idea of where you guys wanted to take this series. And what you wanted to be included into it. My apologies. What you wanted to be included into it and everything. And you weren't even willing to throw a couple of hundred bucks, if not a couple of thousand dollars, at these guys just so you could finish it off. Just so when you put it on YouTube, let's be honest, because Phil has hundreds of thousands of views on those episodes, it pays for itself. You would have made your money back on this and some. And you were so goddamn greedy that you weren't willing to do it. Damn, I might actually have to turn this into a gallon of wine now. We might have to go ahead and go through it just because I kind of compelled to do it now. I'll have to add that to the list because I have some requests too. Let's see. Kenny's coming by later. Okay, so I'll have him go ahead and tell me what's on the list and then we can compile that. Because I need to start getting some of those recorded. Yeah, that's a goddamn shame. Like I said, I really just want the case, but I'll take the replica that's in it. Either that or I'll do a giveaway for the replica. You just don't get the case. It'll be like reverse DSP. DSP would give away game boxes with no games. I'm gonna give away the actual model without a case in it. Oh, that'd be amazing. Good shit. All right, cool. Someone let me know if anybody if someone's a frequent troll over there on Phil's end. Let me know if this thing's still available. I'd very much appreciate it. Here we go.
Lights up. It has a laser pointer inside of it that lists... It's, again, something you'd want to use for cosplay, you know? Really nice. Again, something I was going to use in Project 7, and I never got to use it. I bought all these props that one year, and then it all fell apart, which kind of sucks. So those are the ones that I have not even yet put up for sale, but there is potential that I will sell those figurines, okay? There's a strong chance that at some point I'm going to put these up for sale, either later this year or next year, depending on what happens, all right? So let me put this back, and then what I'm going to do is show
you... Another thing that I should point out, which he's already addressed, is some of those statues aren't even open. When I mean not even open, I mean like he bought it and just put it in the condo and that's it. He never actually opened it up to see if the damn thing was still all together, what it actually looked like outside of the outside box. None of that. So imagine you going to these different cons and so on and so forth and spending all this money on figurines, statues and shit like that. And some of them you didn't even open up. You didn't even look to see if they were in good shape, if they were okay. But you're going to try to pass them off and sell them. Okay. I'm sure there's some type of logic somewhere with that.
The ones that I have put up for sale that unfortunately didn't sell, or they sold but then no one paid. And unfortunately, this is what happens when you do stuff like this. I get the feeling that either the people who bid on stuff were trolls trying to be dicks and waste my time, or unfortunately, in some cases, things just don't come together. For example, the Emma Frost premium format figure. This was actually one of the earlier ones that I tried to sell this year. Only had one serious bidder bid on it, won it, and it was never able to pay for it, so it's just sitting here and it is still available for sale. Again, something like this for around $200, I'd be willing to let this go, even though it's worth a lot more money. The Gears of War Boomer statue. This is the bronze version. What happened with this one was kind of silly, okay? When I went to put it up, or when I filmed the video
walk... This right here should be a telltale sign, and if not, a red flag to any potential buyer. That is very... This isn't just one. When he turned around and said and pointed at Emma Frost, because it was the closest one to him, because, you know, he's a lazy pig, it is what it is. You know what I'm saying? I'd have taken that at face value, moved on it. Okay, one statue that, you know, then someone didn't pay for yet, whatever. It looks like it's a whole lot more than just one. Two, three, and then as he goes further to his left, there's probably a few more that didn't get picked up either. Oh, this is going to be good.
For this one. Boy, that light is bright as shit. Let me aim it the other way. When I filmed the video walkthrough for this one, I looked online and I hadn't seen anyone selling any of these recently, so I estimated like one value for it. Then, during the time period that I was putting this up to sell the statue, someone sold one for like super cheap. So basically the value of this has plummeted since then and no one bid on it. The medic from Team Fortress 2, which, I mean, it had some damage to it, so I can maybe understand why people didn't want...
See, I told you there was a third one that had damage to it. Remember, early on in this broadcast, Phil said two. I said three or more. I was right. Not that that means anything. It's more of a moral victory. It's not like I'm boasting anything at Evo. It's not like I'm trying to boast about anything at Evo or anything, but... Yeah, I knew there was another one, and I still think there's still another one that's damaged. But I didn't remember that one of the Team Fortress ones were damaged. That's too bad, because those were probably worth quite a bit of money. The Team Fortress ones are definitely worth quite a bit of money, because it has a very ravenous fan base and shit. So, yeah, that's just a classic game anyway, so, you know, it is what it is. God damn it, Phil. What are you doing with these things? Were you treating them like they were that Wolverine figurine that you never got? Like, why are so many statues broken when they're supposed to be a statue and just sit on a bookcase, sit on your bar, or whatever? Were you drinking too much gin one night and got mad and... what the fuck, bro? So many of them are broken. Or damaged.
I want to bid on that because the glasses were damaged and I repaired them myself.
Which means they're still damaged.
This one is gone. Darksiders, War and Ruin, I just sold it. And this one will be mailed out by the end of this week, so that one's gone. The Street Fighter Guile statue. Unfortunately, I had a few different parties who were interested.
Which is also damaged. The Saget statue is right below that. I'm wondering what pig reason he's gonna... how he's gonna pig-splain that one off.
And at the end of a week, I had someone who said that, you know, they won the bidding... and never paid, and said they weren't able to pay, so I think that it was just a troll wasting my time. So I still have Guile, and Sagat will be going up for sale shortly. Very shortly. But compared to what we had when I first moved here, I think I've sold a good 5 to maybe 7 statues. Some of the ones I have sold are Dead Space. As I said, the Darksiders will be out of the way. The Black Cat Bust. The Leonardo and the Shredder figurines, the Ninja Turtle ones, both of those have gone. That's just a few. You know, those are just at the top of my head, some of the ones that have sold. So, it's been pretty successful, and it has helped this year, you know, with me raising funds to pay bills and stuff like that. This is what I have left. So
raising funds to pay bills. This is back in 2015, ladies and gentlemen. 2015. This was an active theme that we heard all through 2017, all through 2018. So, if you guys follow, they call me Tex on Twitter. he had said, he had made a comment about this like a month or two ago, that this goes back 5 years, if not longer. And he was right. Oh my God. You know what I'm saying? Like, God damn, Phil. You've been begging for money for almost since the beginning. Almost. Jesus.
Well, if you are interested in Guile, in The Medic, in The Boomer, or in Emma Frost, all four of these were already up for sale and they didn't sell. So if you have an offer on any of those that you'd like to offer me and you live in the United States, send it to darksidephil@hotmail.com and we'll talk. If, you know, if it's something satisfactory, I'll consider it. Any of the stuff you see over here that I haven't offered up yet, do not make offers on it yet unless you're like incredibly, like for example, man, I really want the fucking Hulk. I'm going to make Phil a crazy offer and let's see if he accepts it. That's okay. But, you know, I'm going to probably put most of the stuff over here eventually.
So basically, unless you're going to offer me a shitload of money to where it makes my hooves tingle and I can't resist, then cool. If not, don't send me shit about shit.
Auction. And see what happens in that regard. The Hulk, I don't know. I'll be honest. I don't know if I ever can sell the Hulk because the box is so big. The cost to ship this is probably over $100, no lie. So I don't even know if I'd ever be able to sell the Hulk. That might be something that if I know someone or I meet someone in the area here in Seattle who wants it, and then they buy it, and I, you know, we meet somewhere and I give it to them versus shipping, because the shipping costs would be astronomical. But any of the other ones are pretty, you know, these are normal size boxes. These could probably be shipped pretty reasonably. So, all right, so that's what I got left. You'll be seeing more of these offered soon. If you want to offer anything on these, let me know. By the way, this is the Assassin's Creed Black Flag figurine.
And it's upside down! Goddamn idiot! This is why a lot of those things didn't sell, because most of them are fucking damaged. Shit. Hey, this is the Assassin's Creed, and it's upside down. Thanks a lot, idiot.
What was his name? Edward Kenway? This came with Assassin's Creed 4, and I really like it, but again, I have nothing to do with it. So, you know, if anyone ever wants to make an offer,
yeah, so just go ahead and drop the box on its face, because, you know, want nothing to do with it. I'm trying to sell it, and you can clearly hear there's moving parts rambling around in it. Smart move, Phil. Smart move.
Something like that you can too. All right, that's what I got left. So that's the recap video, and maybe later in the year when I sell through some more of these, I'll do another one to let you know as well.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's... Oh, this show's making me angry! That was making me so angry! I'm mad that he couldn't figure out how to do that properly. Oh my God, I'm so bad how that guy did that dumb shit. He completely botched that. He completely botched that. Oh my God. That was disgusting. That was disgusting. I'm mad that he fucked all that up. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let me give you guys a few particulars before we end this broadcast as it pertains to how he was trying to sell it. And unless you were a hardcore fan who had nothing to hide, you wouldn't have had a problem with it. So you have to reach out to him at darksidephil@gmail.com, or not Gmail, sorry, at hotmail.com and whatnot, because he has a Gmail, but he uses that for something else. So then you guys have a conversation, yeah? Then you have to send this guy basically your first name, full address, so he can go online or send somebody else. He was sending somebody else to do it. To screen you to make sure you're a real person before you guys even talk about money or anything. Or before a transaction can even be considered. This is what he was doing. He was screening people to find out if they were real people and if they weren't trolls, because that's honestly what the situation was back in 2015. And if you purchase something from him, he kind of has the thing hanging over your head that, oh, well, you probably don't want to do anything stupid because I know who you are. You know what I'm saying? You don't want me to dox you, do you? Sounds like Be Awesome One all over again. So that right there was another reason why, and even now, not exactly a good idea to buy shit from Darkside Phil unless you want to roll up to his gated community and buy it from his house, which would be actually rather amusing. Jesus, Phil. Alright, so anyway, that's the situation with that. Most of those statues are broken. I was able to prove it. I will leave a link to Tevin's video down in the description. You can watch it in its entirety. If anybody wants me to go over that thing, it's like 12 videos or something like that. If you want to turn it into like a Gout and Wine or something, or a Wine and Doubt would probably be good. We could do that. We can probably make that happen. I'll add it to the list if anybody's interested. But Tevin already did a video on it. It's a great video. I'll leave it in the description. You can watch it. There's more statues that are broken. I know there is. I'm confident of it. I am confident of it. But that's just silly. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and wrap things up. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening in. I very much appreciate it. This is the Snort Report, and this is DSP News. Always late, never breaking. Unreliable coverage that you can't count on. Oh, yes! A GTG Network of Productions. I am your host slash anchor GTG, and I'm signing off. Have a great day, guys. Have a great day in the broadcast.